Booming Thunder Radio, where we groove as the spirit moves. Yeah. Drawing the honey on the rock with the righteous Reverend Doctor on Booming Thunder Radio.
Shalom, mighty friends and fellow Hanukkah warriors unseen in the earth. Yea, the treasured remnant, the fathers of the faith that bring the feast home unto the Mama Eagle, that she can do her work with the young and nurture and cuddle and coddle and hug and love and hold them and teach them the way of everlasting in the earth, the truth and not the lie. To live in honor and liberty and justice for all in this promised land that the blood sacrifices of our fathers and the blind that know not that vanity, that all is vanity in this world of mystery Babylon. Nothing is real, mighty friends. Everything we've been given is a lie, straight from the pit of hell, to bring each one of us into the misery that they have begotten and brought upon themselves alone, not from their fathers, not from their mothers, but from their heart alone. And they're loving the lie inherited from our fathers more than the spirit of truth which reveals the mystery of heaven. If you will listen to the Mashiach as you study the word and you love the Mashiach, Yahshua, our Hebrew King, the Spirit of Truth, the first begotten mortal man, body transfigured into the glorified everlasting. 3 days later, and Yahshua rose and walked upon the earth with all his disciples, where all the people in the city saw him for 40 days and 40 nights. A spirit of truth in the flesh. See, the Mashiach, God, is not a man. God is pure spirit. And the Father's Son, in the image of his Father, he does his Father's work, faithful to the Father, that he may sit down with his Father at the right hand. Hallelujah. And he did. And he sent the Helper, yea, the Holy One of Israel, that Spirit, the same Spirit that grants all things for those that love Him, those that treasure the depths of the anointed word in their hearts. Yea, mighty friend, let us open the treasured book. Yea, 1793. G 1793. Our brother Thea, the strong man that takes us on the journey. He has bowed on his knees and gave his worship to the Spirit of Truth in his heart, blessing the Father that the Son revealed to each of us, that we may receive the Father's blessing as His forgiveness and His mercy and His grace, and in the same measure that we are able to give those things to the blind and the wretched of the earth. So as our brother Thea takes the end of our blade, he feels the stiffness and the straightness and the edges on both sides that come to the tip that's placed upon his heart. Never knowing until this moment, the Spirit of Truth is who holds the blade upon his heart. And the one that holds the noose around his neck, yea, that one is the glistening reflection of the true temple light, the one Spirit that creates and commands all things, even dawn's early light. And the glistening reflection cast as salt upon the waters. Intukano, something close to that. I don't speak this Greek, and I won't speak Latin. The corrupted nature of men's hearts makes me want to spit whenever I see a Latin word. The corruption of men within the word. This is Mystery Babylon, mighty friend. There is but one language that the mighty one, the existing one, did not corrupt, and it is the Hebrew language. The one all we've been given comes from, and the patterns of evidence revealed, yea, in the mighty Spirit of Truth wielding his sword upon the hearts placing it the tip upon each chest. Yea. As the hangman draws the noose tight around your neck, your only escape, mighty friend, from the oaths that you have taken, from the demons you have worshipped, is to repent of these things and do them no more. Start a new life by waking early before dawn's early light each day and seeking first the kingdom of light, heaven in your heart upon the earth. This is done by praying forgiveness to all those that work iniquity against each of us, knowingly and unknowingly, against each one of us and each one of those that we love and hold near and dear as our family. Yea, even the remnant in the whole earth. Seeking the Mashiach, the living word in our heart, by listening, praying forgiveness for the earth, and listening for the Spirit of Truth to guide you in the living word. Where to place the blade of wisdom, where wisdom, where she will open her pages unto you, as she did to us this day at 1793. And as our brother Thea comes up from the dark place, we hear his definition of G1793. To light upon a person or a thing, fall in with, hit upon a person or a thing. Or perhaps to go to meet a person, especially for the purpose of conversation, consultation, or supplication, mighty friend. Yea, to pray and to entreat. Yea, the faith and the hope and the love in our hearts to make intercession for anyone, yea, hearing the sins of our brother and forgiving in the Spirit of Truth in each of our hearts, our brother's iniquity, giving him the word in each of our hearts to anoint his heart with the truth, that his take the journey with us would begin the everlasting love of the truth. So let us look at our brother from another mother, the Complete Word Study Dictionary, and the G1793 there is to get, obtain, to fall in with, light upon, like a bird upon a wire, to meet and talk, yea, even to listen with such things. In the latter, yea, the latter rain to come to to address, apply to, followed by. These words in Acts 25 and 24. Festus said, King Agrippa, and all you gentlemen here, here present with us, you see this man about whom all the people of the Jews appealed to me, both at Jerusalem and here, loudly declaring that he ought not to live any longer. What such men could decide things? Festus and the king, mortal men? Does not the Mashiach judge all things for the Father and bring justice and mercy for the merciful? Are these men merciful? Have they been judged by a court of their peers? Has there been a quorum or a forum? We may never know. But in the sense of to intercede and to make intercession for or against someone, followed by the expressed or implied meanings of hupa, which is a G 5228, which means on behalf of or for the sake of, a hupa. Yea, a Greek word for over and beyond, a hupa. So let's go over and beyond, mighty friend, and cross over from this wretched Greek mindset taught in Mystery Babylon schools, how to hate and lie with a skillful craftsmanship of a one that would work iniquity with a smile. So let us go to the word study for H 1793, and we see not doka but Dak, oh brother Dak, Daka, it's an adjective meaning destruction, a crumbled substance, an object crushed into powder or pulverized into dust. Thus, by extension, Daka can mean humble or contrite. God is the healer and the rescuer of one who is crushed in spirit. He also lives with those whose spirits are contrite and humble. Yea, Isaiah 57 and 15 is a faithful witness there. For thus says the High and Exalted One who lives forever, hallelujah, for each spotless lamb in the earth, whose name is holy, yea, The existing Father dwells on high and holy place, and also with the contrite and lowly of spirit, in order to revive the spirit of the lowly and to revive the heart of the contrite spirit. Hallelujah. And our brother, the brown driver, short and sweet like the BDB always is, dust, contrite. The ancient Hebrew lexicon Bible, the H1793, is 1080. No, it's not 1080p, it's 1080e. And so the pictograph of the door, that represents the idea of moving in and out, back and forth. And the picture of the palm of the hand representing a bowl from its shape. Combine these two pictures together and you have the moving back and forth in a cup. Seeds are placed in a stone mortar and stone cup, and stone pestle is moved around the cup to crush the seeds into a powder. Yeah, daka. Crushing something that is thin into smaller pieces. Yeah, a wave of crushing of a surfer. The pounding of the powder, the fine dust created in the mortar by the crushing, the grinding, of two stones together. Right now, overweight, and the fine dust powder created in the mortar by the crushing of small or beaten things into smaller pieces. And bruising and stamping and stomping and beating and grinding into smaller breakable. Beating them, crushing them, bruising them, destroying them. Something is broken. Again and again, the contrite and destruction. They trample over these things with the pestle in a mortar. And the stones are placed together. And the trampling down, the treading down, the bruising of their heel. The crouching of the tiger, the wounding of the goat, the ripping of the mortar and the pestle in the bowls of a man's hand. The siege, the engines of war, or the siege works constructed next to a city wall for the purpose of battering it into pieces to allow entry into the city. A siege works. An H1785. The same crushing of bulwark. Dhaka is at its root. Very interesting, is it not, mighty friend? So let us open the treasured word to 1 Corinthians chapter 10. And let not the wiles of mystery Babylon and the deception in men's hearts as they spew their rotted seed upon the ground. We need to avoid these mistakes of those that have inherited and grew up with the lies of mystery Israel, known better as mystery Babylon. Yea, for our Father, the existing one, does not want any of us to be unaware of these things, my fellow, faithful friends, that our fathers were all under the cloud and all passed through the sea, did they not? And all were baptized into Moshe in the cloud and in the sea when they read and it parted before them. And their aprons, like the ribbon, white, red, and now dyed red, like the sea. And all ate the same spiritual food, and all drank the same spiritual drink. And they were drinking from a spiritual rock. Yea, the spiritual rock which followed them. And the rock was the anointed one within the heart of a mortal man. Within the body of a mortal man, the spirit of the living, existing one was brought into the earth to teach the right understanding of the Torah, corrupted by our fathers in their zeal to protect their sons and grandest of sons from evil. Yea, while only concealing the evil and corrupting the locks on their temple doors wrapped around the fists of their hands. Nevertheless, with most of them, God was not well pleased. For they were laid low, do you understand, in the wilderness, fornicators. Now these things happened as examples for you and I, that we would not be so foolish, so that we would not crave evil, yea, the evil things as they have craved the evil, lustful, wicked things in the earth. Do not be idolatrous, as some of them were, as it is written, the people sat down to eat and drink, and stood up to play. Exodus 32:6, the faithful witness. Nor let us act immorally, as some of them did. And 23,000 fell in one day for their immorality. Nor let us try the Moshiach, as some of them did, and were destroyed by the serpents. nor grumble, as some of them did, and were destroyed by the destroyer. Did you understand that? So you better get this 10 and 10, 1 Corinthians 10 and 10. No, don't get it tattooed in the middle of your back. Just remember who does these things. And when he comes, the only one that can cut that noose around your neck or slice that rope from that hangman's post and let you fall back to the earth, forgiven, repenting, never grumbling again. Because if you grumble, as some of those, the ones that came before us, our fathers did, they were destroyed by the destroyer. Numbers 16 and 49. Hallelujah. Now these things happened to them as an example, and they were written for our instruction. For the Torah is for the wicked, those that walk not in the spirit of truth in their heart, that they can find the narrow way, that their cup would be cleansed, and the spirit of truth would indwell within them and begin to teach them. All these examples and all these things that were written down for our instruction, upon whom the ends of the ages have come. Therefore, mighty friend, let him who thinks he stands take heed that he does not fall, to stand, having done all things to stand, that no temptation has overtaken you, but such as is common to man. And God is faithful, who will not allow you to be tempted beyond what you are able, but with the temptation will provide the way of escape also, so that you will be able to endure it. Therefore, my beloved, flee from idolatry. Do you hear? Get out of Mystery Babylon. Seek to understand the holy language of heavens in your heart, in the earth. Yea, I speak as to wise men. You judge what I say. Is not the cup of blessing which we bless, a sharing in the blood of the anointed Son? Is not the bread which we break, a sharing in the body of the anointed Son? Is it? Since there is one bread, we who are many are one body. For we all partake of the one bread. Do you hear? The spiritual food and the spiritual drink. Now, at the nation Israel, are not those who eat the sacrifices sharers in the altar? Well, what do I mean then? That a thing sacrificed to idols is anything, or that an idol is anything? No. I say that the things which the Gentiles sacrifice, they sacrifice to demons and not to God. And I do not want you to become sharers in demons, mighty friend. You cannot drink the cup of Mashiach and the cup of demons. You cannot partake of the table of Mashiach and the table of demons. Or do we provoke Yahushua HaMashiach to jealousy? We are not stronger than he, are we? All things are lawful, but not all things are profitable. Do you understand? All things are lawful, but not all things edify. Let no one seek his own, but that of his neighbor. Do you understand? Seek the good of your neighbor, how to serve your neighbor. Yea. Let the water can be made deep. Eat anything that is sold in the meat market without asking questions for conscience' sake. Do you understand? For the earth is the existing Father, Mare Jehovah, and all it contains belong to him. If one of the unbelievers invites you and you want to go, eat anything that is set before you without asking questions for conscience' sake. But if anyone says to you, "This is meat sacrificed to idols," do not eat it for the sake of the one who informed you and for conscience' sake. I mean, not your own conscience, but the other man's conscience. It's not about you. It's about the you within your heart, the spirit of truth, and the humble, contrite spirit which you are, less of you and more of him, the you. No billy goats, only spotless lambs. I mean not your own conscience, but the other man's. For why is my freedom judged by another's conscience? If I partake with thankfulness, why am I slandered concerning that for which I give thanks? Slanderers, whether I forgive you in your blindness. Whether then you eat or drink or whatever you do, do all to the glory of God. Give no offense either to Jews or to Greeks or to the church of God. But as I also please all men in all things, not seeking my own profit, but the profit of the many, so that they may be saved. Mighty friends, all that come willingly to receive shall be filled. You only have to have one thing. The love of the truth within your heart. So be groovy, mighty friend. Ye be imitators of me. Just as I also am from the anointed Son, who is in all the remnant. He is in all of you, spotless lambs, humbled bond servants. Now, I praise you, spotless ones, because you remember me in everything and hold firmly to the traditions, yea, not the lies, but the truth, just as I delivered them to you. But I want you to understand that the anointed Son is the head of every man. Do you understand? The mind of the man, or the mind of the anointed Son? The anointed Son is the head of every man, and the man is the head of a woman. And God is the head of the anointed Son. Do you understand? Every man, this is the Christian order. If things are done in this way, morality, justice, and the innocence of our children, yea, guarded from the evil, idolatrous ways of cross-dressers reading children's stories in public places, unconscionable. These acts are not what this great nation were founded on, and the freedoms this great nation possesses shall not be trampled on by such wretched, unglorified nature. Ye, mighty Father, let your will be done on all such unrepented hearts, Father. Strengthen them that they can find the truth. And ye, mighty one, do the work of the living word upon each of their hearts. Yea, upon each of our hearts, that we could each be sifted by the God we worship and perfected into the right understanding, which is the living word made flesh and circumcised upon your heart. Every man who has something on his head while praying or prophesying disgraces his head. But every woman who has her head uncovered while praying or prophesying disgraces her head. For she is one and the same as the woman whose head is shaved. Do you hear? You better get that 1 Corinthians 11, verse 5, ladies. For the word is true. And it says, if your head's not covered, that it disgraces your head. Just as a woman whose head is shaved disgraces herself with her morality or lack of it. And all these temple prostitutes, these whores of mystery Babylon that shave their heads, yea, all the women in all the earth that pray and prophesy without their head covered, they're all women, like temple whores. It ain't me saying it. It's the word, 11. 1 Corinthians 11 and 5. There it is, right there. Deuteronomy 21 and 12. The end and then the beginning. 2:1, 1:2. For if a woman does not cover her head, let her also have her hair cut off. But if it is disgraceful for a woman to have her hair cut off, and it is, or her head shaved, yea, let her cover her head. And let them that suffer from the pharmakia of men, let them call upon the Mighty One of Israel to be healed, that their head would receive hair once again. For a man ought not have his head covered, since he is the image and glory of God. But the woman is the glory of man. Hallelujah. Genesis 1 and 26 for the faithful witness. For man does not originate from woman, but woman from man. Do you understand? Genesis 2, 21 through 23 is the faithful witness. For indeed man was not created for the woman's sake, but woman for the man's sake. Therefore the woman ought to have a symbol Therefore, the women, all of them, the woman ought to have authority on her head because of the angels. Do you understand? Authority on her head because of the angels. Do you understand? Therefore, the woman ought to have authority on her head because of the angels. Let her head be covered that she can command the angels, for the glory of the man she was made to bring joy in his heart to. However, in the Mashiach, Yahushua HaMashiach. Neither is woman independent of man, like some believe they are, nor is man independent of woman. Yea, she makes him whole, and she filled, and he fills her heart and her very soul with his love, the love of the Father. For as the woman originates from the man, so also the man, through the woman, and all things originate from God inside our hearts. The great temple light. Judge for yourselves, is it proper for a woman to pray to God uncovered? Does not even nature itself teach you that if a man has long hair, it is a dishonor to him? But if a woman has long hair, it is a glory to her. For her hair is given to her for a covering. Do you understand? But if one is inclined to be contentious, we have no other practice, nor have the churches of God. But in giving this instruction, I do not praise you. I don't praise you because you come together, not for the better, but for the worse. For in the first place, when you come together as a church, I hear that divisions exist among you, and in part I believe it. For there must also be factions among you, so that those who are approved may become evident among you. Therefore, when you meet together right now, is it not to eat the Mashiach's supper? Yea, the existing Father's everlasting glory, his supper, that spirit, and not the table, a supper of demons. For if you're eating, each one takes his own supper first, and one is hungry, and another is drunk. Do you understand? No? Or let's go again then. So therefore, when you meet together, it is not to eat Yahshua's supper, for in your eating, each one takes his own supper first. And one is hungry, and another is drunk. What? Do you not have houses in which you eat and drink? Or do you despise the church of God and shame those who have nothing? What shall I say to you? Shall I praise you? In this I will not praise you. Yahushua's Supper. For I received from Yahushua that which I also delivered to you, mighty friend, that Yahushua HaMashiach, in the night in which he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, yea, the night he was betrayed, he took the bread and broke it, and said these words. As he broke the bread, he said these words. Are you listening? This is the Mashiach's words coming forth. Are you ready? This is my body, which is for you, spotless ones. Break this bread. Yea, when you do this in remembrance of me, the Spirit of Truth, indwelling within your hearts, renewing the refreshing on the Sabbath day with your family. In the same way, he took the cup also after supper, saying, are you listening? He broke the bread first, for it is his broken body in the earth. And then he took this cup. This cup is the new covenant in the blood. Yea. When Yahushua spoke it, he spoke it like this. This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink in remembrance of me. So it's the cup that is the new covenant. It says nothing about the wine. It's only about the cup and the breaking of the bread, not the eating of the bread or the drinking of the blood. But it's about the cup that the Spirit and the bread can be poured and gathered around. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim Yahushua's death until he comes. Do you understand? John 21 and 22 will help you. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's, Yahushua's, death until he comes. What shall we do to proclaim his life until he comes? The life in us. Therefore, whoever eats the bread or drinks the cup of Yahushua in an unworthy manner shall be guilty of the body and the blood of the Anointed Son. guilty and an unworthy. So the church, our brothers, have focused on the wine is the blood, but the wine has nothing to do with the blood. It's not what it says. It's the cup. It's the willing vessel that is the new covenant in the blood that he gave, that you can be filled with the bread of life and drink from the cup of everlasting. And always with the right understanding of the living word, and never in an unworthy manner, that we could be found, the remnant could ever be found guilty of the body and the blood of our existing father's son slain in the earth. But a man must examine himself, and in so doing, he is to eat of the bread and drink of the cup as he examines himself. Matthew 26. No, not 2600 this time. 26 verse 22 of Matthew. For he who eats and drinks eats and drinks judgment to himself if he does not judge the body rightly. So when you are taught by the cup to drink the wine and take the wafer that becomes Christ in your mouth, I see none of that in the word living in my heart. I see only the things that for he who eats and drinks judgment to himself if he does not judge the body rightly. For this reason, many among you are weak and sick, and a number sleep. Acts 7 and 60 for the faithful witness. But if we judged ourselves rightly, are you listening? We would not be judged. But when we are judged, we are disciplined by Yahushua HaMashiach so that we will not be condemned along with the world. Ye set apart. So then, mighty friend, my brethren, when you come together right now, over way to eat, wait for one another. Do you understand? So then, my brethren, when you come together to eat, wait for one another. So that as we break the bread and drink from the cup and remember doing all things for the glory of God, as we do them before our children, even the grandest of children for thousands of generations before our table, the table of Mashiach. If anyone is hungry, Let him eat it home before he comes, so that you will not come together for judgment in your ignorance. The remaining matters I will arrange when I come before you. Yea. 1 Corinthians 1 Corinthians 11 and 33. So then, my brethren, when you come together to eat, wait for one another. This is the way, the narrow way, that sets men free from the bondage of being weak and sick. Deliverance from cancerous things of, yea. Now that you believe in the Spirit of truth can be manifested within your heart. Now, concerning spiritual, yea, the spiritual gifts, brethren, mighty friend, I don't want you to be unaware. You know that when you were pagans, and we were all once pagans, knowingly or unknowingly, you were led astray to the mute idols. However you were led, you know how it was, it doesn't matter. Therefore, I make known to you that no one speaking by the Spirit of God says Yehoshua is accursed. No one can say Yehoshua is the anointed Son, the everlasting glory in the earth, except by the Holy Spirit. Now there are varieties of gifts, but it's the same Spirit, mighty friends. Do you understand? It's one Spirit. And there are varieties of ministries, and the same Yehoshua governs them all. There are varieties of effects, but the same God who works all things in all. But to each one is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. For one is given the word of wisdom through the Spirit of truth, and to another the word of knowledge according to the same Spirit. To another faith, hallelujah, by the same Spirit. And to another gifts of healing by the one Spirit, and to another the effecting of miracles, and to another prophecy, and to another the distinguishing of spirits, to another various kinds of tongues, and to another the interpretation of tongues. But one and the same Spirit works all these things, do you understand? Distributing to each one individually just as he wills. For even as the body is one, and yet has many members, and all the members of the body, though they are many, are one body, so also is the Anointed Son. For by one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, whether slaves or free, and we were all made to drink of one Spirit, the one, yea, true God of Israel. For the body is not one member, but many. If the foot says, because I am not a hand, I am not part of the body, it is not for this reason any the less a part of the body. And if the ear says, because I am not an eye, and if the ear who hears says, because I am not an eye who sees the great temple light before them, I am not part, I am not a part of the body, it is not for this reason any the less a part of the body. If the whole body were an eye, where would the hearing be? If the whole were hearing, where would the sense of smell be? But now God has placed the members, each one of them, in the body, just as he desires. If they were all one body, yea, and all one member of that body, where would the body be if it was one member? It would not be a body at all, would it? It would just be a member. But now there are many members, but only one body. And the eye cannot say to the hand, do you understand? The eye and the hand. The eye in and the palm of the hand. Do you understand? And the eye cannot say to the hand, I have no need of you. Or again, the head to the feet, I have no need for you. On the contrary, it is much truer that the members of the body, which seem to be weaker, are necessary. And those members of the body which we deem less honorable, on those we bestow more abundant honor, and our less presentable members become much more presentable, do they not? Whereas our more presentable members have no need. Do you understand? What is presentable and what is less presentable? Remember, all things are legal, but not all things edify. Not all things are profitable for the glory of God, which let each step and breath we take be endeavored to persevere in this way. But God has so composed the body, giving more abundant honor to that which lacked, so that there may be no division in the body, but the members may have the same care for one another. And if one member suffers, all the members suffer with it. If one member is honored, all the members rejoice with it. Now you are the anointed Son's body, and individually members of it. And God has appointed in the ecclesia first apostles, second prophets, third teachers, then miracles, hallelujah, Yahshua, then gifts of healings, helps, administrations, various kinds of tongues. All are not apostles, are they? All are not prophets, are they? All are not teachers, are they? All are not miracles or workers of miracles, are they? All do not have gifts of healing, do they? All do not speak with tongues, do they? All do not interpret, do they? But earnestly desire the greater gifts, mighty friend. Let your desire be for the greater spiritual gifts. And I will show you a still more excellent way to come before the glory of the everlasting Father. Hallelujah, Yahushua HaMashiach, the Sabbath day King of glory. Yea, let him reign in your heart and say, do you know what time it is? Yea. Let us go to HebrewPie.com and search for those two faithful witnesses. Yea, there at the top. And let's look there for 6 and a 5. HebrewPie 65 in the latter rain. Let's plug it away and pop over to HebrewPie 65, inviting them to enter. Is the title. So the image of our mind is a man and his bride, both with their heads covered. A prayer shawl around the man's shoulders, and a tight creped dress around the bride's neck. They dress in black and white and dance. Yea, the man, filled with the glory, dances before his bride. Hebrew Pi 65, the sum is 357. Yea, like a magnum, 357. And if we go to the complete word study, we see that Hebrew H357 is a proper noun designating an AI. Yea, a halon, an J. An AI, journey, alon, which is an oak. Hebrew for the word oak, in English, alon. So it is a bull working machine. You like that? Bull works up against the wall, hammering down. Just by walking around, a nice little stroll and a blasting of the trumpets once more. Ayalon. It's a name that refers to two cities. A city in the territory of Dan, but was not captured by Dan. It was a Levitical city, a place where both people of Ben-Jasin and Ephraim lived. Ben-Jasin and Ephraim lived and was reinforced by Solomon's son Rehoboam. Later, the Philistines captured it. It's also a city in Zebulun, Elon, a judge, was buried in it. Its exact location is unclear. The brown driver, Ayalon, or AI with the J in the oak trees. The BDB definition of AI Halon is field of deer. A Levitical city in Dan, 14 miles or 25 kilometers northwest of Jerusalem, is where the field of deer is. Later ruled by the Amorites, then the Benjaminites of Yehuda, then by the Philistines. A city of Zebulun, site unknown. And for all those that come to the knowledge of the glory and have rejected it and turned away, from Hebrew into the Greek mindset, let us see what the strong man says about these denoting distribution, distinction or repetition, to reckon or to think, to consider things accurately and distinctly or again and again, such as we see in Hebrew 12 and 3. For consider, there it is, G, 357, consider him who has endured such hostility by sinners against himself, so that you will not grow weary and lose heart. Consider this. Our brother Thea definition of G357 before we go into the kitchen, come out the woodshed, get the fire going under the kettle, get the coffee boiling in the pot. The Thea definition is to think over, consider, or ponder past decisions they made when they turned away from the holy mindset language and back to the Greek goddesses, the pantheon, that are under the rule of the Mashiach. And they do all these things of vanity for all the blind of the earth, because the Father is good and gives them the desires of their heart from the word that they speak, even in their ignorance. And so, mighty friend, Hebrew Pi 65, inviting them to enter. Surrounded with humility, we go hunting for the tabernacle hidden behind the pillars, where his revelation flows from the depths of the living water found inside. Mighty Yahuwah has begun to gather us with his liquid light that connects heaven to earth, a reward found now, for it is the appointed time. Righteous ones who have come through the door, their veils removed, nourished by the reward. Their cutting tools go forth, cutting the veils before the poor. The Ruach breathes upon us, for he is the master teacher of all. The revelation within Torah is the illumination which connects Yahovah to the hearer. Yea, those who have seen and know all. Our life is fulfilled by drinking in revelation of Torah. It is the action where apostles and prophets help the poor man through the narrow gate. Righteous ones now connected, for they have entered into the tabernacle found deep inside. The breath of the Ruach is what has opened their eyes, inviting them to enter in and stand before the ark that is awaiting in the depths of your mind. Oh, hallelujah, mighty friend. Yea. Have you heard the old bullfrog calling your name? Were you born on the bayou? Were you born by the you of the spotless lamb? Does the bayou within you, mighty friend? Could he possibly be in you in any kind of way? Oh, Come on now. Oh, you know you can do it. Come on, let's go skip some rocks. Yeah! Come on! Cool water flow, y'all. Let me remember the things I love, Father. Dancing in the moonlight. Bullfrogs calling me, yeah. Wondering if my rope's still hanging from the post.